Well, you've talked a lot about the communication with the tenants. I know when you get several units, it can be kind of overwhelming to just prioritize and remember all the different situations that are going on. Mm-hmm. So what maybe system or tool or software have you put in place to make sure things don't get forgotten?
I'm a spreadsheet guy personally, so I like to track our rent roll and any notes on tenant communications in there. We've recently switched over to using Buildium as well, which is a great tool, which we need to leverage more because that's going to be a great place for tenants to submit maintenance requests, also for our team to assign tasks to each other in there internally and have one central hub that everyone can go into and see what needs to be done and see what kind of outstanding issues there are. So it's a great tool that we're working on utilizing more. But it is a slower implementation process with that because you do have to train the tenant base to use it. And a lot of these people have been, under a certain owner for 10 years. And it's always just been this, casual situation of, rent collecting rents in person and maybe a letter going out here and there. So getting people switched over to a newer system usually takes some time and some training, especially if they're in an older demographic. They might not be as excited to jump on board with an online platform like that. But
yeah.
I think it's going to be a huge value add as we continue to train the tenant base and get right. people switched over to that.
Yeah, those new software tools, where they're not really all new, but new to some people, those are really valuable.
Yeah.
But getting tenants to adopt them can be a big challenge.
Yeah.
Any success stories of people that you've converted?
Something we're working on now is creating an incentive to at least pay online. It could be, just a $5 or $10 discount on rent or something like that. That seems to have some traction so far. But otherwise, it's just consistency with the message and having my manager or, whoever you're utilizing, make sure there's a consistent message to the tenants that, this is the way that we're going to be doing things going forward. But I think offering some kind of incentive above just the reminders is a good tool as well. So people are going to save a couple of bucks. That usually gets people to take action.
Yep, for sure. Even that $5 can go a long way.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's worth it.
Did you review several management softwares before you landed on Buildium, or what made that decision for you?
Not really. I mean, it was basically I used a software called Tenant Cloud that I signed up for when I got my first property. Wasn't too excited about that. There really was no customer service to it. And it was useful for collecting payments online, but outside of that, it wasn't a very user-friendly system, at least as far as I was concerned. And then I did some research online and basically came down to Buildium and Appfolio. And while interviewing property managers, I came across Yardi as well. But the ones I kept hearing about talking to people in this space and the multifamily space and syndicators was Buildium and Appfolio. And I believe Appfolio has a minimum number of units. I want to say it's 100, something in there. A little bit higher price point, but it almost always seems to make sense at a certain point if you have enough units. So making the jump to that one is going to be inevitable, in my opinion. So Buildium seemed to make sense for under 100 units. You still get some robust features there, and the price point was pretty good. I can't remember off the top of my head what it was per month, but it wasn't a big outlay of cash, so it was definitely worth it if you utilize it to its fullest. And then I think once you get into more units, Appfolio seems to be the winner from most people I've spoken with.
Want to hear more on this topic? Click the link below for the full episode of Maximizing Your Property Value.